Welcome back. Now, a look at the other events in the state.
South Goa Journalists Association celebrated Tilak Jayanti at Madgaon, Wednesday. Many journalists from Madgaon were present at the function. They garland the portrait of Lokmanya Tilak. Theatrist Sid Silva, one of the senior most theatrists, has demanded apology from former Fathodda MLA and chairman of Ravindra Bhavan Damu Naik. Silva said that Damu should have taken theatrists into confidence before forming a committee.
आमचे पॉलिटिक्स काहीच ना आणि कोण विचून काढले आता काही आम्ही काहीच म्हणत ना पण आमचं एकूच आमचे मागणे आहले आमचं मनीस तिथून पावचं आलो पण दादा दमबाब तुवें आमचे विरुद्ध प्रचार केला हो सारखो न्हय म्हणून तुवें मानून घेवचे आणि आमचे थिएट्रिस्टां लागीं चूक मागची अशें म्हाका दिसता.
South Goa collector Andy Agarwal feels that poverty is the root cause of human trafficking in the country. He was speaking at the concluding function of anti-human trafficking workshop organized by the South Goa police. Locals from the Akem Bash Panchayat have complaints of the garbage menace in their area. Have a look. Heap of garbage can be seen dumped in prohibited areas.
जाल्यार जातलें एक पंचायती कडेन हें करून बाबा पंचायतीन काडचो अशें जायना न्ही तें कॉर्पोरेशन जाय लोकांचें कॉर्पोरेशन हितून तें जर जायत जाल्यार गोंय क्लीन जातलें. सेकेंडली जें गार्बेज जावपाक मेन कारण आमचें प्लास्टीक ही प्लास्टीक टोटली बॅन करपाचो म्हाका तर दिसता.
ब्युरो रिपोर्ट, प्रुडंट मिडिया.
एंड नाव न्यूज फ्रॉम स्पोर्ट्स. Salgaocar Sports Club coach Karim Bencherifa believes that the Indian Football League needs to be restructured in totality. The I-League that is running is neither improving in standard nor is it marketable to make clubs get some revenue at the moment. The player transfers is haphazard with no rules on when to approach the players for signing, no transfer fees and no criteria on the imports.
One thing that is quite strange in Indian football is that the foreign players that our clubs sign, they just come on 1 year contract. Isn't it time that clubs tie up the players for longer contracts? Because everything gets affected when a season is over. They get some offers, big, unrealistic maybe at times, they switch clubs. So what do you think of that?
Well, I don't have much to say about it. Is the overall professional setup that we have in our league that make this happen. And bear in mind, the solution is not signing player 2 years, you're going to solve this, the situation. Need a professional setup where maybe there will be a time when to approach players. And I think now I'm not saying everybody, like by the end of the season everybody is talking to everybody, and it need a bit of rules and but that's not my job.
Transfer fee has to be there
because you even for example you take for example a club, this is happening in Europe for example, when a club we for example Salgaocar, we had and I heard even a local club called Margao Sports Club. I do agree with what they are claiming, because when a club, and it's happened to us also at Salgaocar, debate regarding the IPL, first of all, I see it as a healthy debate, because we are trying, everybody is given an opinion and talking, that means everybody is concerned, and everybody wants Indian football to improve and go to new heights.
Yeah.
But we have to be also a little bit careful, because whatever going to happen.
You can watch the entire interview of Salgaocar Sports Club coach Karim Bencherifa in Simply Sport on Saturday. Bureau Report, Prudent Media.
Tilak Stadium in Vasco is the venue for I-League football in the 2012-13 season. The stadium is in need of repairs and the government is well aware of this. The Sports Authority of Goa Executive Director Elvis Combs has been on record that they will strive to complete all the work to make Tilak Stadium ready for the I-League by October.
Here is a look at how the Tilak Stadium looks like as of now. The amount of work that the football facility needs is huge. The time is limited because the I-League will begin sometime in October. No denying that Sports Authority of Goa will have a race against time to finish the work of renovating the present infrastructure. Moreover, installing the new floodlights will be another challenge if a monsoon prolongs. The government will have to quickly complete the paperwork and get the work started as soon as possible. A reporter from Vasco, Surendra Matkekar.
If you have missed our bulletin, log on to www.prudentmedia.in or follow us on Twitter at Prudent Goa or meet us on Facebook at www.facebook.com/prudentmedia. And with this, we come to an end of this news bulletin. Keep watching Prudent Media.